Well, good morning, good morning, good morning. It is good to be with you this morning to give worship and praise to our Lord Jesus Christ. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen. I'm going to go ahead and invite Holy Commotion on up here. Eliana Nelson has now been promoted to, drum roll please, worship leader. I thought it'd be fun. She's going to lead us in our opening prayer. And so please rise as you're able and bow your heads and let us pray.
Dear Lord, thank you for bringing us together this morning to worship you. Open our hearts to you, Lord. Thank you for the day and help us worship you. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And so, this is your part. I was going to say our first hymn, but that's y'all's. Let me sit down and y'all can take it away and we'll just jump into worship.
Yes.
Please join us in singing, "Here I Am to Worship."
Light of the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see. Beauty that made this heart adore you, home of the light spent with you. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. King of all days, oh so highly exalted, glorious in heaven above. Humbly you came to the earth you created, all for the sake became poor. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. Never know how much it costs to see my sin upon that cross. I'll never know how much it costs to see my sin upon that cross. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me.
Our next song is a new one called King of My Heart. It gets like really high, so like if you want to stop singing or like drop the octave, that's cool.
Let the king of my heart be the mountain where I run, the fountain I drink from. Oh, he is my song. Let the king of my heart be the shadow where I hide, the ransom for my life. Oh, he is my song. You are good, good. Oh, you are good, good. Good, good, oh, the king
song. Let the King of my heart be the fire inside my veins, the echo of my days. Oh, He is my song. You are good, good. Oh, 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 You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You are good, good. Oh, You are good, good. Never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let me down.
Last song we are singing is Shine, Jesus, Shine.
Yeah. Lord, the light of Your love is shining in the midst of Your darkness, shining. Jesus, light of the world, shine upon us. Set us free by the truth You now bring us. Shine on me. Shine on me. Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. And mercy, send forth Your word, Lord, and let there be light. Lord, I come to Your awesome presence, from the shadows until Your radiance. By the blood I may enter Your brightness. Search me, try me, consume all my darkness. Shine on me. Shine on me. Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze. Set our hearts on fire. Thank you.
shine on me, shine on me, shine, Jesus, shine, fill this land with the Father's glory, blaze, Spirit, blaze, set our hearts on fire, flow, river, flow, for the nations with grace and mercy, send forth your word, Lord, and let them be light.
Amen. A round of applause for Holy Commotion. Hey, please be seated. We're going to jump into children's time. Our children's story time this morning is the Beatitudes. And so come on up, kiddos. You can have a seat here on the front steps. We're going to hear the story of the Beatitudes. And then y'all can sneak on down to Sunday school and play games and hang out and color and do crafts and all of that good stuff. Oh, all right. The Beatitudes. Question, did any of y'all know what Beatitudes means? Ooh, it means blessings. So we're going to hear about blessings this morning. Beatitudes means blessings. So news that Jesus was coming had spread all over the town. Maybe he will make sick people well, some people thought. Maybe he will make hurt people walk, thought others. Everyone wanted to see Jesus. There were so many people, how would they all be able to see him? Jesus knew. He climbed partway up a mountainside and sat down. Now all the people could see Jesus. Everyone waited. Someone yelled, "Quiet! I want to listen." "Shh," mothers told their children, and then Jesus began to teach the people. Jesus said, "People who feel hopeless are blessed because God will give them heaven. Sad people are blessed because God will help them feel better. People who don't have many things are blessed because God will give them everything they need. People who want to follow God's ways are blessed because God will help them. People who treat others with kindness are blessed because God will treat them with kindness. The people who know what is right in their hearts are blessed because God will be with them. People who make peace are blessed because they will be called God's children. People who are hurt because they try to do what is right are blessed because God will give them heaven." Wow! So many blessings. Did Jesus have anything more to tell the people? He did. Jesus told the people, if other people don't like you and they hurt you and say bad things about you or tell lies about you because you are my friend, you are blessed. Be happy because God has a special place for you in heaven. The crowd became noisy. People were smiling. Jesus had blessed the people. What a day. So, today, y'all get to go downstairs and talk about blessings and to be blessed. And before you go, can I pray a blessing over you? Would that be all right? All right, repeat after me. Dear God, we ask a blessing on our kiddos as they learn and grow in you. Amen. Amen. I'm excited to see what you'll learn. And last week, I skipped my favorite part, and that was letting you show off your crosses. So I have pictures of them during our announcement time. So I get to show them, but y'all will be downstairs, and so you'll miss it. But just know that I wanted to hear what y'all get to do downstairs. Would you be wearing a shirt? Yeah, always? I know, yeah. All right, if any of y'all are all going to come up, it is always good. We're going to sing Thy Word. Holy Commotion is going to lead us as y'all head on out. Let us sing together.
shine a light onto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I feel afraid, think I lost my way, still you're there right beside me, and nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will not forget your love for me, and yet my heart forever is wandering. Jesus, be my guide and hold me to your side, and I will love you to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Amen. And so I don't know if you could gather it from our opening hymns, our opening songs, I should say, but we get to focus on salt and light in worship this morning. I do want to show you these. These are some of the crosses that our Sunday schoolers made last week when they were talking about light. And they are painted, I do believe, with glow-in-the-dark paint. Is that right? Somebody help me out here. I'm pretty sure it's glow-in-the-dark paint. Yeah, I got a head nod. And so, right, the light shines through them, and they get to reflect that. And even in the darkness, they continue to glow. Ain't that true of Jesus? Can I get an amen? Amen. And so, a few announcements this morning. Oh, there's another picture of the crosses if you want to flip one more slide. Yeah, there you go. I have that one as well. I want to share that. Hey, SPY is this week. We get to have SPY. So St. Paul Youth happens this week, Wednesdays. It's for our 7th through 12th graders, 6 o'clock. And I hear we're baking things. We're baking taste testing things. All right, so that sounds pretty cool. So if you are in 7th through 12th grade, come on, invite your friends. It should be good. Right after this, I don't know if y'all saw the, I was going to call it commotion, but I don't want to have to associate that with this beautiful magic that happens here. This will be more chaos, less magical, but we're going to stomp grapes. We're going to make grape juice. We're going to make wine, maybe. We'll see. But we want to talk about First Communion. And so for those of you who haven't had First Communion yet, this is an opportunity to jump in, bring your whole family. If you're also just curious about what it looks like to watch somebody stomp grapes, and this is a rigged operation, do not expect professional. I did not phone anyone in from Napa to see how they do it, so it should be fun. Come hang out with us, come learn with us. It should be fun as we talk about communion, specifically wine. We're going to talk about bread in a month. So for those of you who are planning attending today, mark your calendars next month, March 5th, right after, again, Holy Commotion. We're going to have another commotion back there. So March 5th for that. I think I've got another slide up here. All right, so Ash Wednesday, we are going to jump into a sermon series by Kate Buller. If you don't know that name and you're working through grief, you should know that name. One of her favorite books that I've gotten to read was Everything Happens for a Reason and Other Lies That I've Loved. right? And so she talks about her story. You can even just get it's a 14-minute YouTube video if you want the cliff notes. It's a TED Talk. Google it. Kate Buller, TED Talk, Everything Happens for a Reason, and Other Lives That I Loved. I can help you find it too. But we're going to go with her for our Lenten series. It's going to start Ash Wednesday. That's February 22nd. And we're going to go with her every single Wednesday all the way up into Holy Week. And then she's actually going to carry us through Holy Week and into Easter Sunday. And so we've got this big, long theme. And fun enough, her theme is blessings. And so blessed are them, are we, a mess of contradictions and our deep and our delusions and deep hopes and our fragility and finitude. And so she just has a way with words. Come check it out. It should be amazing. Oh, I also want to let you know, and I feel like it's my duty as senior pastor to let you know, we've hired 3 more pastors. I didn't tell council about this, surprise council. We've actually hired 3 more pastors. If I could get the next slide, here's one of them right here. Right? So there's Pastor Spencer. He's here this morning, as well as Elijah helping him out there. Next pastor. There's Briella leading us in confirmation right there. And then lastly, Pastor Claire there baptizing an infant who has been dropped by accident on the floor. And so, confirmation class continues. We're learning about baptism and communion. And so just wanted to share those pictures with you because they brought me joy. Clearly, they bring you joy too as well. I think that's all that I need to share as far as announcements go. Is there anything that I'm forgetting? I take time in the middle of worship to share what's happening outside of worship because church is more than just an hour on Sunday morning. It's all of these things that we get to do. More so, it is the way that we live our lives, that we get to be a reflection of Jesus in everything that we do. Can I get an amen? I'm starting to sneak into my sermon, so let me pray. And then we'll get into scripture, and then I'll actually go into my sermon. So bow your heads with me. God, you have called us to be your people. You have shown us your light in Jesus Christ, our Savior, and called us to be salt for the earth. Help us to reflect your love in everything that we do. Bless us when we are down and out. Pick us back up, dust us off, and call us again to your side, that we get to be a witness for you in everything that we do. That church is not just an hour on a Sunday, but it is a way of living out this faith thing, this love thing that we have come to know in you. And so in Jesus' name we pray, and all God's people say, amen. The scripture that I want to share with you this morning comes from Matthew, the 5th chapter, beginning with the 13th verse. It goes like this. You are the salt of the earth, but if salt has lost its taste, how can its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything, but is thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hid. People do not light a lamp and put it under the bushel basket. Rather, they put it on a lampstand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. I do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets, Jesus says. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill. For truly I tell you, until heaven and earth pass away, not one letter, not one stroke of a letter will pass from the law until all is accomplished. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does them and teaches them will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I tell you, unless your righteousness exceeds that of the scribes and Pharisees, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. This is the gospel of the Lord. We say praise to you, O Christ. So the Lord be with you. So salt and light, that's what we get to talk about this morning. How Jesus calls us as Christians to be salt for the world, is what he says. Right? To let our good deeds so shine before others that all the world might glorify our Father in heaven. Right? We, dear people, are called to be models of Christian love. We get to be a living witness to Christ, so much so that even if people don't know Jesus from Scripture or from going to church, and many people don't anymore, that they do get to know Jesus from the way that we live our lives, right? You and I, we are called to be living testimonies of Christ so that our Father in heaven might be praised. Can I get an amen? So let's talk about Christian love and Christian witness, and we're going to use salt and light as examples in hopes that it helps us know a little bit more about who we are called as Christ followers. That sound good to you? Say yeah? All right, cool. So salt. Salt. We put it on our food because food tastes better with salt. At least that's what I think, right? Food tastes better with salt, right? One time I was making potato fries for a group of friends. I was having a house party over, and I went a little bit overboard with the salt. Like everywhere. Like just everywhere salt. And one of my friends described my cooking as bold. And I took it as a compliment. I took it as a compliment and I ran with it because salt adds everything to fries, right? But more so, how many of you sprinkle a little salt on a freshly picked garden tomato? Do you ever do that? Take a big bite, sprinkle a little salt, take a bigger bite, sprinkle a little more salt. Or on watermelon on a really hot day, you take a nice slice of watermelon, you sprinkle a little salt. Do you need to do this? Oh, some hands, you should. Yes, yes, learn from the best, right? You should, because salt just makes things taste better. And that's what I want for you, right? To add flavor to other people's lives. I want you to bring the joy of knowing Jesus Christ to others, that we are called to share this with others, that it's not something that we just keep to ourselves. It's something that we share to sprinkle the hope that comes from knowing the love of Jesus on others, right? To be the kind of people who take money and put it in an envelope and leave it anonymously for somebody you know who is struggling. To be the kind of people who pray for those that maybe no one else is going to pray for. To take this love that we have come to know in Jesus and sprinkle it all over strangers and friends alike. And you know what? When you share the love of God, this love that God has for us and that we get to have for those around us, be bold. Go overboard. Be extravagant in sprinkling that love of Jesus around, so much so that people will say, God, so-and-so loves putting salt on things. Right? Overflow with that generosity and joy and kindness that comes with knowing the love of Jesus, and may God's name be praised through it. Can I get an amen? But more so, did you know that salt, it's not just flavoring? Did you know that salt is essential for life? Right? Salt, as you know, is a compound of two elements, of sodium and chlorine, which are broken down into the ions and electrolytes that our body uses to function, that it is only with those electrolytes that our bodies can conduct the tiny electrical signals that our brain, that our nervous system, that our muscles need to function. Basically, without salt, without electrolytes, our bodies cease to function correctly. Right? Movement becomes harder, malnutrition sets in, disease runs rampant because our immune system is compromised without salt. And funny enough, I have noticed the same thing in my life without Jesus. Right? That I can try to live without Jesus, but my head doesn't seem to function as well as it could. That my brain just seems a little bit off without Jesus. That cynicism and despair and self-hate can so easily take over, as if it is the love of Jesus that keeps all of this whole and healthy. right? And you know what else? My nervous system seems to get a little bit off without that salt electrolyte of Jesus, that things seem to go a little haywire because your nervous system is the thing that helps you feel. Did you know that? Your nervous system is the thing that helps you feel things accurately. And I have noticed that when I am lacking in my salt, my electrolyte, my Jesus, are you still with me? That when I am lacking in that I feel less for my neighbor. That I can become numb to other people's problems, that I can become selfish in my ways and insular in my thinking, and that is not what God has built us for, is it? We get to feel for our neighbors. We get to care for our community around us. We get to reach outside ourselves to care for and to bless others. That's who we are called to be as God followers, as Christ followers, as Christians, right? May God our Father be praised through it. Can I get an amen? One last thing that I'll say about salt is that I love jerky. I love jerky. Any of y'all like jerky? Anyone? Yeah, and I'm not talking Slim Jims. Slim Jims are gross. I am talking about, so I got you, some of you are like, Slim Jims are amazing, you shut your mouth, Pastor, right? I am talking about real jerky. I am talking about the homemade, dried in the attic for like a year, crusted in salt sort of jerky, the kind that you stick in your mouth and it's just hard as a rock and you chew on it for hours and hours and you've got to work the flavor out of it, right? It's not just something you just relaxingly chew on. You've got to be like just hold it, right? The kind of jerky that you take camping and you don't care about it expiring because it will last for weeks. Because it's got that much salt in it. Y'all know what I'm talking about? Yeah, right? Refrigeration was the thing of a past, and before refrigeration, salt was a way of preserving food from keeping it from going bad. Right, the reason that bacon was took on the Oregon Trail across the West was because it kept, right? It's delicious. I'm with you on that. More so, it was so packed full of salt, it kept. And when you know the love of Jesus, and when you share the love of Jesus, you are giving people the love of Christ that lasts not for just this lifetime, but that lasts for eternity. Right? The love that is forever. And may God be praised through that as well. Can I get an amen? Amen. If you have a heart condition and I keep talking about salt, forgive me. Let me switch to light. Maybe that helps. I was thinking about this last night as I was trying to get to sleep about what it means to be a light of Christ. And my wife loves reading at night by candle in bed. And I was under the impression that beds were for sleeping. I know, silly me. It's for reading at night with a candlelight. And the thing that I have noticed is that it does not matter how much I position a pillow over my face or manipulate the covers over my head, somehow that candle's bloody light creeps in, right? Does anyone else have this problem? Right, and it doesn't have to be a candlelight. It can be the hall light or the light under the door. In college, I lined my windows with aluminum foil to keep the light out. And yet, it always found a way in. It always found a way in. And I'm going to switch metaphors on you here. Forgive me for that. But what does it look like to be the kind of light that brings the love of Jesus into the places that are dimmest or hardest? Right, that the world can try to keep you out or put you out, but shine anyway with the love of Jesus. Shine anyway with the love of Jesus. Did you know that a human eye can see a candle, a single candle, at over a mile? And what's it look like to be a light for others who are on their journey, who are looking for their way, to guide them, to be there for them, to shine for them? What's it look like to be a light for others? Because sometimes this world can seem so dim. This world can seem so dim, and what's it look like to shine, dear people, so that God's name in heaven can be praised? Allow me to share one story and then I'll sit down. There's a church in the Twin Cities that had dwindled down to like 20 members. And they decided that if they were going to go under, they were going to go under doing the thing that Jesus called them to do. And so they quit putting money into their building, and they quit investing in insular things, and they printed 600 flyers offering to help anyone in their community with anything that they needed, regardless of church affiliation or non-affiliation. And they passed them around. And of the 600 flyers, two people responded, and they showed up, and they helped those people. And then word began to spread that this church will just come and help. It doesn't matter who you are or where you've been. They're not trying to convert you or evangelize or anything that. They just want to be a church who reflects the love of Jesus. And so now they fix toilets and gutters and people's plumbing. And they repair porches, and they paint siding, and they repair roofs. This is where this church puts all of their energy. And people come to their church because they are living the gospel, that they aren't in it for themselves, that this is a church that feels for their neighbors, that they live out their calling, and God in heaven is praised for it. And you know what's funny? It's years down the road now. That church is still there. They're still broke. But they're still there, right? They're living the gospel. And what's our call as a church, dear people? What's our salt and our light, right? We are in a time of figuring out our mission and our ministry here. What kind of church are we going to be? And more so, what's God placing on your heart this morning? And go be it. Go be it. And may God be praised through it. Can I get a final amen? Amen. And so we get to transition back to Holy Commotion. Y'all come on up. We get to sing together our sermon hymn, which also doubles as our offering hymn, In Christ Alone. Right, this is where our salvation is found. Let us sing together.
My strength, my song, this cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still with striving seas, my comforter, my all in all. Here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on the cross as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid, here in the death of Christ I live. There in the ground his body lay, light of the world by darkness slain. Then bursting forth in glorious days, all from the grave he rose again. And Smashing hands in victory. Since Christ has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. No guilt in life, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever block me from his end. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever block me from his hand. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand. Here in the power of Christ I'll stand.
And so we get to enter together into a time of prayer, right? To lift up our hopes and our fears, our worries, just whatever's there, right? And I can start us off, and then as you feel called, just lift up what's on your heart. Sound good? Cool. Good and gracious God, we give you so much thanks for Jesus Christ, our Savior. Your reminder that we are salt and light for your name and for your glory. It's not about us. It's not about our praise, our glory. It's about yours. That we get to live for you, that we get to shine for you. And point others to you. Keep working here within us, within our hearts, within this church. And guide us in your ways. Lord, in your mercy. Hear our prayer. Hear our prayer. Lord, in your mercy. For Dean and for Cody and for Abby, Lord, in your mercy. Those that feel lost or are looking for direction, for those of us who struggle with addiction or depression or anxiety or all of those things that seek to claim us, Lord, be with us. Give our hearts peace. Lord, in your mercy. Other prayers. God, I thank you for the gift of our youth, for the gift of Holy Commotion, and for just the ways that our youth shine in you, that share the joy that they have in you, and you can just see it in their eyes. And so we thank you for them and just ask a blessing on them. School can be so hard, life can be so hard, and that is true for all of us. Walk by their sides, walk by all our sides through this week to come. Lord, in your mercy. And so we lift up these prayers, those that are spoken aloud and those that are whispered on our hearts, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, and all of God's people say, Amen. So if you want to grab that communion packet, that we get to remember in the night in which he was betrayed, how our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks and broke it, saying, This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And again, after supper, he took the cup and he gave thanks and he gave it for all to drink, saying, This cup is the new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me. And so, gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray that prayer our Lord Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. And so take back that plastic layer and grab the body there, that bread there. This is Christ's body given for you. Take and eat. And then the foil, right, the grape juice. This is Christ's blood shed for you. Take and drink. And receive this blessing, dear church. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. We say amen. Amen. I want to give you a blessing this morning before you go, kind of a lead into our Lenten theme. This one, though, comes from Jan Richardson. This poem is entitled, Blessed Are You Who Bear the Light. I figured it was appropriate for today. Blessed are you who bear the light in unbearable times, who testify to its endurance amid the unendurable, who bear witness to its persistence when everything seems in shadow and grief. Blessed are you in whom the light lives, in whom the brightness blazes, your heart a chapel, an altar where in the deepest night can be seen the fire that shines forth in you in uncountable faith, in stubborn hope, in love that illumines, in every broken thing it finds. Can I get an amen? Amen. I'm going to go ahead and invite Holy Commotion back on up here for our singing hymn. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. And if you want, everybody, you gotta reach in your pocket, and then you get to pull out your light, right? You got it? Everybody's got a light, and you can let it shine. Not gonna hide it under a bushel. Not gonna let anybody blow it out. You got your lights. All right. I'm excited. It's y'all.
Please stand and sing with us.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Hide it under a bushel, no, I'm gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bushel, no, I'm gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bushel, no, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Don't let Satan blow it out. I'm gonna let it shine. Don't let Satan blow it out. I'm gonna let it shine. Don't let Satan blow it out. I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine. Let it shine. Let it shine. Shine around the neighborhood. I'm gonna let it shine. Shine around the neighborhood. I'm gonna let it shine. Shine around the neighborhood. I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine. Let it shine. Let it shine.
Oh, man. All right. Dexter, what would I do without you? What would I do without any of y'all? Like, right? Like, this service would just be me here talking without y'all. Y'all bring the joy and the energy and help me find my spot. Come on up. You can stand here.
I'm a rock and a bee.
There's a bee. All right. All right. A bee. The Beatitudes.
It's a flock.
It's a what?
It's a flock.
A flock? A flock of bees?
Yeah.
A whole group of bees?
Yep.
A what? Said? A fly. Thank you. It's a fly, right? And it shows all the Beatitudes and you can spin it and read it?
Yeah.
Oh, you could have somebody read it to you?
Yeah.
Pretty cool. I bet Liam can read it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And we also did this crossword puzzle, and some of us are still working on it, and some of us finished it.
All right, well, pretty cool. With all of that said, go in peace, dear church, shine with all the love of God, and be salty in Christ Jesus our Lord. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen.